idea. So when they're starting this, a lot of people, and in my basic obedience classes I teach this, when you walk and you stop, your dog stops with you. But if you are moving, the dog is staying by your side, right? This is one of the components that makes the down in motion so much more difficult than maybe some of our other plans, because it's counterintuitive to what we've trained our dogs to do. Now, just like with everything else in dog training, we're gonna start slowly, right? If I'm walking like this and I tell my dog, who never has done this before, down, the dog's gonna go, and it's gonna keep walking. It might look confused for a second, but that's as far as it will go. So basically, just because I haven't yet clarified, what a down in motion is exactly what it sounds like. It's having your dog at a heel, right? And it's saying down, and while you continue walking, your dog lays down on command and stays there. And then you can go two places from there. You can either heel, and they run up and heel again, or you can leave them there, walk around a little. There should be an implied stay. If you tell them to down, they should not get up and follow you just because they did it. So that's going to be one of the factors we'll be teaching here, is that implied stay, which I think is very important. Now, if you do your implied stay, hopefully everybody has a release cue for their dog, like an okay or something to tell them to go. Use that. Yep, you're totally fine. Give it 1 second, just because I want to make sure the lecture is 100%. Yep, and if you guys get warm, move in the shade. Yeah, that will keep the dogs a lot happier as well.
Should have bought a hat.
Well, it was super cold this morning.
Yeah, that's why I dressed up.
I know, I've been wearing this hoodie. I'm like, down. So this is the person that my And right, I'm just gonna down. Start here. Make sure she's being patient. And then, okay.
Regularly.